special mode. Special modes of mode of reproduction. Under this, we have to learn two concepts: special mode of reproduction. Two concepts we have to learn. First one is apomixis. Apomixis, and the second one is the polyembryony. Apomixis and polyembryony. What is meant by apomixis? Apomixis can be defined as the development of a new individual, or it is a type of asexual reproduction. It is not sexual reproduction. Apomixis is a mode of asexual reproduction in which a new individual or seed is formed without the formation of gametes and their fusion. So, apomixis is a type of asexual reproduction, is a mode of asexual reproduction in which a new individual implants seed, refers to the new individual. So, a new individual or a seed is produced without the formation of gametes and their fusion. This is called as apomixis. So, apomixis, the plants or the organisms where apomixis take place is called as an apomate. So apomate is a plant or an individual where apomixis takes place. Such plants are called as apomate. And this as a result of apomixis, because apomixis where reduction division is not taking place, that is, gametes are not formed, fertilization is not taking place, that is, the embryo is not formed as a result of sexual reproduction. So, all the progenies that are produced are genetically identical to the parent plant. Therefore, they are called as clones. Genetically and morphologically similar offsprings, similar to the parents, are called as clones. So this apomixis produces clones because it is an asexual mode of reproduction. Gametes are not formed, meiosis does not take place, reduction division does not take place, and the fertilization does not take place. Therefore, genetic recombination is not there. As a result, all the progenies that are produced are genetically identical to the parent plant. Therefore, they are referred as clones. Apomixis is an asexual mode of reproduction, but it mimics sexual reproduction, especially the seed formation, including seed formation. It mimics sexual reproduction without reduction division taking place or without fertilization takes place. So it is a type of mimicry. Apomixis is a type of mimicry. It mimics sexual reproduction including the formation of seeds, because here reduction division is not taking place, gametes are not formed, and their fusion, the fertilization is also not taking place. It is a genetic phenomenon. Apomixis is controlled genetically. Genes are responsible for apomixis. Apomixis is controlled by genes, that is, it is a genetical phenomenon that is taking place in the plant. Now, the apomictic seeds are produced as a result of development of diploid embryo that is formed without fertilization. A diploid embryo develops into a seed. Without fertilization, it is taking place. So, it is a because it is a somatic cell and the reduction is not taking place. It is a diploid embryo that is developing into the seed. So, the apomictic seed is a result of diploid embryo or the development of a diploid embryo. Without fertilization, apomictic seeds are formed. Example where apomixis that takes place are grass. Grass is an example where apomixis takes place, and some plants belonging to the family Asteraceae are examples for apomixis. These are the two examples that is given in your NCERT. So what is apomixis? Apomixis is an asexual mode of reproduction where the new individual or the seed is formed without fertilization. It is called as apomixis. And apomixis, such plants where apomixis takes place are called as apomict. And these are, the offsprings are clones because they are identical to the parent plant. Why it is identical? Because no reduction division, no meiosis, no genetic recombination, no fertilization. Therefore, they are referred to as clones. So, apomixis is a type of mimicry. That is, it mimics sexual reproduction including the formation of seeds without the gamete formation or their fertilization. Apomictic seeds are formed due to the development of diploid embryo that is formed without fertilization. And it is a genetically controlled mechanism or genetically controlled phenomenon, and genes are responsible for apomixis. Examples where apomixis takes place are grass and certain plants belonging to the family Asteraceae. So this is about apomixis. Next special mode of reproduction is polyembryony. Now polyembryony, look at the term. Poly refers to many. Embryo. So many embryo present inside the seed. This is polyembryony. Usually in one seed, one embryo, in one ovule will develop into one seed. But here in a seed, many embryo is present in the seed, and this phenomenon is called as polyembryony. Occurrence of more than one embryo in a seed is called as polyembryony. So what is polyembryony? It is the occurrence of more than one embryo in the seed is called as polyembryony. Usually what happens? This is the embryo sac. And embryo sac is surrounded by nucellus. We learned it is surrounded by the nucellus, which is the nutritive tissue. This nucellar cells undergoes division mitotically. So this nucellus is diploid. Nucellar cells are diploid without undergoing meiotic division. That is, it undergoes mitotic division. As a result of mitotic division, the new cells that are formed will protrude into the embryo sac and behave as embryo. So many embryo are present inside the embryo sac. So the nucellar cells surrounding the embryo sac undergoes mitotic division. It remains diploid, it pushes or penetrates into the embryo sac and behaves as a embryo. This embryo are diploid but is formed without fusion of the gametes. So this is how polyembryony takes place. Examples where polyembryony takes place are lemon, orange, onion. These are some examples where polyembryony is seen. And this polyembryony has got a very important significance it has got, because many embryos are there. This many embryo, because of the presence of many embryo inside the, so that this is the embryo sac. Later it will develop into the seed. So inside the seed, instead of one embryo, many embryo are there. Embryos are there. So the significance is that these embryos can be isolated and grown or cultured in a medium, aseptic medium, under artificial conditions through micropropagation. Each embryo can be developed into a different plant. So the embryo growing into one seed, we can get many plants at the same time we can get many plants from the seed, because because of the presence of many embryos. So this many embryos can be isolated, grown in an aseptic condition, in vitro, in an artificial medium, through micropropagation to produce large number of plants from a single seed without, that is in a very less time. We can produce many plants. This is the significance of polyembryony. Many plants from one seed having many embryo. This is called as polyembryony. So, definition of polyembryony, occurrence of more than one embryo in one seed is called as polyembryony. Now, the significance of fruit. What are the significance of fruit? The first significance of fruit is that the fruit protects the seed. The seed is present inside the fruit, which is a very unique characteristic feature of angiosperm, where the seeds are present inside the fruit. In gymnosperms, the seeds are naked, that is, it is exposed. But in angiosperm, the seeds are present inside the fruit. So the seeds are protected by the fruit. The fruit protects the seed. That is the first importance of fruit or significance of fruit. The second one is that the seed that is present inside the fruit helps in seed dispersal or the dispersal. That is the when the fruits are eaten by, say for example, the bird eats a fruit. The seed will be inside, and if it is not digested, when it is not digested, the birds carry it and the seeds fall along with its droppings in a faraway place. The seed grows there into a plant there. So seeds help in seed dispersal. That is another significance of the fruit. So fruits are eaten by animals and it helps in seed dispersal. The third significance of fruit is that the remnants of the fruit that is present around the seed facilitates it to germinate. That is, seed germination of the seed is facilitated by the remains of the fruit. So what are the significances of fruit? The first one is that the fruit protects the seed, or the seed is protected by the fruit. That is the first significance of fruit. Second significance is that the seeds that are present inside the fruit helps in seed dispersal. So seeds are taken at different places, and when the seed falls in one place, it germinates into and grows into a plant in there. In a faraway place, the seeds germinate. So fruits help in the dispersal of seed, and say the fruits help or facilitate seed germination, or the seed germination is facilitated by the remnants of fruit present. So these are the significances of fruit.